very much. What better a guy to have here tonight during World Series week than Mr. Baseball? Anyway, some 20 years ago, 1964 to be exact, I was a member of a World's Championship club, the St. Louis Cardinals. And this being our 20th anniversary, they had their 20-year reunion this year. And I actually found out about it through the grapevine. I didn't get invited. They told me they had a like a mix-up in their mailing deal, so I did call, and they did invite me after I called. And I mean, going back and seeing all those guys, it was truly unbelievable. I can remember riding in the cab with my uniform on to the ballpark, and getting to the ballpark and getting out of the cab, and my wife and the cab driver standing there, and you know, like, we stood around like for about an hour, and there were no people there. So I thought, well, maybe they built a new ballpark in St. Louis. And we checked a Yellow Pages book, and sure enough, they did have a new ballpark. So back into the cab and down to the new ballpark, and there is where I really almost fell over. I got out of the cab, and there's a statue of me outside the St. Louis ballpark. It's a little screwed up. They have me like batting left-handed, but I was a right-handed batter. But you know, like, the uniform and everything else is the same. And she's right on the bottom, the guy's name, big letters, some guy named Stan the Man. I guess he made it. Did a beautiful job on it. And you know, once you are a member of a World's Championship club, there are numerous money offers. I mean, very lucrative money offers. And I took the one that was best for me from the Rawlings Sporting Goods Company. A tremendous amount of money paid to me, never to be seen in a piece of Rawlings equipment. But, anyway, what I want to... Oh, I'm sorry. I guess these things happen sometimes on a live show. Oh, okay. Well, something a little bit more important, I'm told. There's a phone call coming through that they want me to take on the air, so...
Stand by for the president, please.
Gee, I've seen this happen on TV in locker rooms, but this is...
Hello, Bob. This is President Reagan calling from the White House.
Hello, Mr. President.
Well, let me just say, as an ex-sportscaster myself, that, well, based on tonight's show, you've got a heck of a career ahead of you as an ex-sportscaster. Of course, I'm just kidding.
Thank you, sir.
And it's... Well, it's my privilege to have this small part to play in the gala premiere broadcast of your 10th anniversary season on the air.
Well, speaking for everyone at this end, sir, I'm sure we're all extremely grateful for your kind words, even taking into the account that our first actual, the premiere was last week. But it's still most
appreciated. Now, of course, I know your premiere show was actually last week, but... Well, as you may imagine, I was a little bit busy last Saturday night. I had to get ready for my disaster. But seriously, Bob, I would just like to take a moment to clarify a couple of things that, well, if the opposition had their way, people would just remain confused about.
Well, that'd be great,
first of all,
sir,
let's get one thing clear. On the subject of taxes and Social Security...
Yes, sir.
No matter how hard my opponents or the media try to insert some weasel words into it, I'm not going to raise taxes or cut Social Security. And nothing short of something pretty darn important can make me change my mind on that.
Well, the only thing I think...
Now, Bob, I know you folks have a pretty full show to get on with. And, well, besides that, you probably can imagine it's a little late for a fellow with all of my responsibilities to be staying up and watching TV, let alone calling it on the phone.
Well, I guess what
so
I want...
So thanks to the good people in the White House Radio TV office, we take this call earlier this afternoon. And it's being fed to you now from our videotape room. Say, how about that ball game this afternoon? You know, that kind of thing to me is what the World Series is all about. Anyway, Bob, let me just make it clear that during that debate last Sunday night, I wasn't intending in any way to compare abortion either to murder or to remodeling your kitchen.
No, I'm sure.
Bob, as I said, I'm sure you've got a lot of show to do. Once again, my congratulations and Nancy's. And of course, I have some makeup to take off. I'm wearing some tonight. And my sincerest wish as well that, well, you're with Saturday Night Live for another 10 years. Bye-bye.
All right, anyway, kind of a thrill. We can kind of speed up the rest of the sketches. Maybe I can finish my monologue. We'll be right back.